Hello everyone, welcome again. In this lecture, we are going to study water transport through the xylem tissue. Now, xylem is a tissue which conducts water and minerals to the various parts of the plant. When plants absorb water from the soil by their roots, this water should have to conduct or reach, it should be reached up to the all parts of the plant. So, this conduction of water is carried out with a tissue. The tissue is known as xylem. So, xylem is a water conducting tissue. Now, let's see what are the types of or what are the cells of xylem's tissue. Xylem tissue is made of four cells. That cells are tracheids, vessels, xylem, parenchyma. Fourth one is xylem fiber. Xylem fiber. So these four cells made xylem tissue. Now these tracheids and vessels are the cells which conduct water. These are water conducting cells. And these are dead cells. These cells are dead. And this xylem parenchyma is a living cell. This is a living cell. Again, this xylem fiber is a dead cell. When xylem develops or at the earlier stage of xylem, it is living. But as soon as it goes certain developmental changes, it gain day or it will day at its maturity. When it get mature, the cells of xylem get day. Only the xylem parenchyma will be act as living cell, and all the cells of xylem will considered as dead cell. At the earliest stage of xylem, the xylem cell is the living cell. Xylem is living at earlier stages, but due to certain development or at the maturity, the cells or the xylem get dead. At the maturity, xylem cells become dead. Only the xylem parenchyma act as the living cell of xylem. All other cells, that is tracheids, vessels and xylem fiber, are considered as dead cell of xylem. This xylem fiber is also known as sclerenchyma. Xylem sclerenchyma, which is a dead cell. After maturity, there is some deposition in the cell wall. That deposition is nothing but the lignin. It is the secondary metabolite which provides strength and rigidity to the plant. This lignin deposition will be occur at the cells of the cell wall of the plant, and that lignin deposition will give strength and rigidity to the plant. Hence, when xylem is considered as dead cell, it considered that there is obviously lignin deposition. Now we will see these four cells one by one, how these cells conduct water from root to the tip of the plant. Now let's see tracheids. So, tracheids are the
easy,
long, narrow and tapering end, sails, which have pores present on it. Suppose if this is the facade which is narrow, long and tapering end, that means narrow end is referred as tapering end. This facade will be overlapping. Overlapping facades and no end-to-end, joining of these facades. Suppose this is the one facade. Let's draw another facade. These facades are long. Narrow and tapering end. This is the second facade. This is the first facade. And it contains pores adjacent to each other. These facades contain pores adjacent to each other. Through this pore, water is transferred. So water will be transferred through these pores in zigzag manner. You can see the zigzag manner of water transport. Hence, in this way, water is transferred from one tracheid to another tracheid to the lateral tracheids present in a xylem cells. Now, this water transport in a zigzag manner. These are the tracheids. Tracheids are the long, narrow, slender structure with a tapering end, which are present at the overlapping structure. That you can say, these are present at the overlapping structure. See here, this is the end of this tracheid, but this second tracheid is not joining to this end. It is overlapping on first tracheid. So the position of this tracheid is overlapping, and the pores that is present on this tracheids are adjacent to each other. When waters move through this pore, they show zigzag manner transport. So in this way, water is transferred through zigzag manner from one tracheid to another. So several tracheids are there in the xylem cells which carry such transfer of water through the pore in zigzag manner. So this is about tracheids. Let's see another cell of xylem, that is vessel. Now vessel is second cell which conducts water. This vessels are large and wider than tracheids. These are large and wider than cookies. Its wall is perforated. This wall of this vessel is perforated. What is perforated mean? Perforated means having pores. Perforated means having pores. Suppose if this is the one vessel, this is another. They are attached in adjacent. This is another vessel. This will form another vessel. Now, the pores are present at the walls of the vessels. The pores are the structure from which water moves from the one vessel to another. So, this is the end wall which is perforated. Now, perforated means having pores. So, pores are present at the end and water is moved through these pores. So, water is moved through these pores. So, these are the vessels which is larger and wider than truckies, and these walls of vessels contain pores through which water is moved or water is conducted. So, these are the vessels which constitute the xylem. These are large, wider and shorter than trochees, and this wall of the vessels contains some pores. Water moves through these pores from one vessel to another. Vessel is absent. Vessels absent in gymnosperms. So gymnosperms do not have vessels in their xylem cells, but exception is there, that is meatum. One exception is there, meatum. This meatum genus, although it is gymnosperm, it's having vessel in their xylem cells. When in a plant vessels, in a plant xylem is present, then vessel is also present. Then that plant is considered as, or it is having porous wood. If a plant contains xylem and in that xylem vessels are present, then the wood of that plant is known as or is referred as porous wood. An example is angiosperms. So in angiosperms having porous wood because in xylem cells vessels are present. But if in a plant xylem is present but the vessels absent, then the wood of that plant is non-porous. An example is gymnosperm. Examples are gymnosperms. So gymnosperms are referred as non-porous wood plant because in the xylem vessels are absent in the gymnosperm. So these are the two cells. Let's see the third cell type. xylem, parenchyma. Xylem, parenchyma. As we have already discussed, this xylem parenchyma is a living cell of xylem. Living cell of xylem, and it is soft and thin. It is soft and thin. Its function is to store food. Food storage and translocate the water. So it also function as lateral translocation of water. Lateral translocation of water. So these are the xylem parenchyma cells. Fourth type is xylem fiber. Fourth type is xylem fiber. This xylem fiber is a dead cell. Is a dead cell and hard structure. This xylem fiber is a dead cell and it having hard structure. Thus, it is a dead cell or hard structure. It provides mechanical support. It provides mechanical support to the plant. So due to this xylem fiber, which is hard structure, it contains dead cells, and this xylem fiber helps to provide mechanical support to the plant, so that plant could be stand without collapsing. So these are the four cells of xylem tissue. If we consider xylem as a dead cell, then the cells of xylem, if xylem is a dead cell, then cell of xylem, the cells of xylem do not have cytoplasm. It also do not have cell organelle. Cell organelle like mitochondria, chloroplast, but it is having cell wall. If we consider xylem's tissue is a dead cell, then that xylem cells contain this. There is no cytoplasm, no cell organelle, but only cell wall is present. So that's why water is moved through this xylem cells in bulk amount or in more amount, because there is no restriction or no obstacle for the conduction of water. That's why this bulk amount of water is conducted. Why? Because this cell do not have any obstacle or any restriction to flow. That's why, because this cell do not possess any cell organelle or it do not have cytoplasm. So the path of the water for the conduction is free. So that's why bulk amount of water is conducted through the xylem cells. So these are the four cells of xylem we have discussed. I hope you have understood very well. Thank you for learning.